she was not home by noon, as she had plans to go play tennis with her boyfriend at 12:30. When she did not return, Patty went searching for her along the usual bike route, but could not find her and called the police. Several witnesses saw Tara riding a bicycle around 11:30 a.m. Some also saw a white or grey pickup truck following closely behind. She and her bike have never been found. It's widely believed she was kidnapped, as 20 years later, a disturbing Polaroid picture of a young woman and a boy, gagged and bound, was found in a store parking lot in Florida. Tara's mother was convinced this woman was her daughter, and noted that a scar on the woman's leg was identical to the one Tara had. Scotland Yard analyzed the photo and concluded this was Tara, but a second analysis by the Los Alamos National Laboratory disagreed. An FBI analysis was inconclusive. The woman who found the photo said it was in a parking space at the Junior Food Store at Port St. Joe, Florida, where a white windowless Toyota cargo van had been parked when she arrived at the store. She said the van was being driven by a man with a mustache who appeared to be in his 30s. Relatives of a 9-year-old boy, Michael Henley, also of New Mexico, came forward, believing that he was the boy shown in the photo. Michael was last seen on a camping trip with his father in April 1988, and his remains were discovered in June 1990 in the Zuni Mountains, 7 miles from the campsite. Police believe that Michael wandered off and gotten lost, as the cause of death was ruled as hypothermia. They did not believe he was the boy in the photo. FBI analysis was again inconclusive. In 2013, a man named Henry Brown made a deathbed confession to police. He said shortly after Tara's disappearance, he had been in the basement of a man named Lawrence Romero Jr. While there, he noticed what appeared to be a young woman's body wrapped in a blue tarp and buried in a makeshift grave. Romero, a man named Dave Silver, and another man told Henry the body was Tara's. They said that on the day of her disappearance, they, along with a fourth man named Leroy Chavez, were in a truck when they noticed her riding a bike. While trying to get her attention, they accidentally hit her, then abducted and raped her. When Tara threatened to go to the police, Romero stabbed her. They were apparently able to get away with the murder, as Romero's father was sheriff at the time. He and the other parents allegedly helped to cover up the crime. Henry also told investigators he believed they later dumped Tara's body in a pond near one of their houses, and her bike had been disposed of at a junkyard. Another man also came forward, saying that one of the suspects had confessed to him as well. Romero Jr. later committed suicide in 1991. However, Tara's body has not been found, and no charges have been filed against the other suspects.